Just give me a moment.
Sure.
सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमावस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुतिस्मृति पुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ रक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावतीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणिजातिगुरुवेदाश्चित्रणम् प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। आमुनायन्ते संसिद्धमादिमध्यान्तः आनन्दघनमापूर्णमात्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। फर्स्ट सूत्र वी आर लुक एट टू वी आर येट लुक एट द सिद्धांत। वी सॉ दी पूर्वपक्ष टू दैट एज टू एष एव साधु कर्म कारयति श्रुति एंड दी रागादि वशात् स्वतैव आत्मन कर्तृत्व संभवात् तत् प्रतिपादक विधि विद्यादि शास्त्रेण विरोध अस्ति इति पूर्वपक्ष। सो स्वर्ग काम यजेत इज अ विधि विच इज एप्लीकेबल टू अ कर्ता। इफ वन इज नॉट अ कर्ता हिमसेल्फ देन दी विधि इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल। एंड अनदर श्रुति सेज एषः परमात्मा ईश्वरः ही एव साधु कर्म कारयति। ही मेक्स दी पर्सन एक्ट देयर फॉर ही इज दी कर्ता हेतु कर्ता रियली। सो विच इज दी विरोधा देयर। बोध श्रुतीज हैव विरोध। सिद्धांतस्तु सिद्धांति सेज इट इज नॉट सो। वाई सौत्र तू शब्द दिस तू शब्द परात्तु तच्छ्रुते हे देर प्रदा परात्तु दैट तू शब्द सौत्र तू शब्द मीनिंग सूत्रगत तू शब्द पूर्वपक्ष व्यावृत्यर्थ। इट इज टू रिफ्यूट दी पूर्वपक्षी हिज ऑब्जेक्शन। नाउ दी जीवा हू इज सेट टू बी कर्ता इज ही कर्ता बाय हिमसेल्फ। ही इज अ कर्ता ऑल राइट बिकॉज इट हैज ऑलरेडी बीन एस्टैब्लिश बट इज ही अ डिपेंडेंट कर्ता और एन इंडिपेंडेंट कर्ता। वी ऑलवेज सी दैट दी कर्ता हू इज स्वतंत्र वेन ही इज नॉट डिपेंडेंट देन ही स्वतंत्र। देयर फोर एज मेन्शन यस्टरडे व्याकरण सूत्र जो है स्वतंत्र कर्ता बट ऑल्सो वॉट तत् प्रयोजक हेतुश्च। Now swatantram is there, definitely swatantram is there, meaning he has no dependency on other karakas. But it is not that he is not prodded to act. So hetu karta is ishvara, dini karta is ishvara, na swataha jivasya kartrutvadi siddhihi. This kartrutva bhoktrutva of the jiva is because ishvara is karma phaladata, tracking the karma, and if the karma is such that some phala is due, which the jiva may or may not want in another janma, Ishvara has to create a setup and has to let the samskaras manifest in that janma, in that prarabdha, so that the karta feels like doing. The final choice is still with the karta, but the circumstances are made in such a manner and his mind is configured in such a manner that he would feel like acting out so that the phala due is given to him. Or he may generate more karma phala by acting out, generate more punya or papa as the case may be. So this is the dependency. The dependent karta has swatantram in choice, in his free will, in acting out, but in everything else, Ishvara has to be there to make him act. Without Ishvara, Karta cannot be a Karta at all. Therefore, there is a dependency. Kintu Parat, Parat in the Sutra, Parat, Parasmad Ishvarat. From this, Para, who is Ishvara, Paramatma, Ishvara, Karmadhyaksha, who is the Adhyaksha, who presides over all the karmas of all the jivas and keeps track. Track meaning it is not like Chitragupta taking notes, but then By Swabhava itself, he knows all the karmas of all the jivas of at all times, and thereby he does what is needed for the karta to become bhokta and then to generate karma and for the cycle to continue. So karmadhyakshad parat, from due to this paramatma, due to this paramatma who is karmadhyaksha, karmadhyakshad avidya timirandasya kartrutvadi samsara siddhihi. So parasmadishwarat, this karta who is jiva acting out, he is what? He is under the veil of avidya. Otherwise the jiva is not different than paramatma. The jiva considers himself as a karta bhokta, and Bhagavan says, okay, I bless you, remain karta bhokta by continuing the veil on the swarupa of the jiva. So he does not know he is paramatma at all and thereby remains a karta bhokta. That is also another way whereby Ishvara is causing a dependency for the karta unless he breaks out by jnana. So the avidya timirandasya, due to the avidya which is tamarupa, causes such a pitch darkness or a veil so that the jiva does not know anything about his swarupa and continues to be associated with the shariratraya, and the cycle continues, becomes a samsari, remains a samsari. He was a samsari, and in this janma also he continues to be a samsari. So the he is blinded by that pitch darkness. He is blinded. Andhasya kasya kartuhu purushasya jivasya. Who is that jiva? Avidya timirandha. Due to avidya, which is tamorupa, he is blinded. Avidya timirandhasya kartrutvadi samsara siddhihi. So kartrutvadi padena bhoktrutva, all that the jiva considers himself to be, that is only because Ishvara is blessing him the way he wants to be. It is not that Ishvara is tying up without his wanting. Jiva wants to be a samsari. He wants to try to get as much sukha as he can with Vishaya. Therefore, that samsarana is possible only because of Ishvara, who is letting the jiva get what he wants. Tad anugrahetu vijnanena moksha siddhir bhavishyati iti. So for bandha also Bhagavan says tathastu. For moksha, the person who is a seeker, for him also Bhagavan is going to say tathastu. What you want, I'll give you. If you want to remain in the instinctual behavior with the artha and kama pursuits, then continue there, be it as a human being. But if you want to have cruelty and such gunas which are not becoming of a human being, then might as well give you some animal life where krurata is a norm. So become a simha in the next life. If you want to kill as simha. Get over those desires, then maybe you will have a refined human birth whereby you can progress. So that is on the one side. On the other side, if the seeker, if the human being wants to be, the jiva wants to be sadhaka and get moksha, he is a mumukshu, then tadanugrahe, ishwaranugrahe, paranugrahe, paramatmanaha anugrahe sati, to vijnanena moksha siddhir bhavishyati. Then in that very life, the jiva will get moksha through vijnana. Kutaha, how do you say so, says the Purva Pakshi. What is this dependency on Ishvara for samsara as well as bandha as well as moksha? So there Bhagavan says, the Siddhanti says, tat shrutehe, because of such a shruti, this is Moola. Tachrutehe, because such a shruti exists. Esha hiyeva sadhu karma karayati. So what you think is that esha hiyeva sadhu karma karayati has virodha with the vidhi pratisheda karmakanda mantras, it is not so. Why? Because esha eva sadhu karma karayati is based on the desires of the jiva. So jiva is still a karta, but the hetu karta is Ishvara. There is no reason for there to be virodha. Just because there is a hetu karta, your mother makes you do something, you want to do something, the mother helps you. You do not want to do something, the mother says you don't do it. Okay, she supports you there also. Or in some cases, she knows better than you, she knows what is good for you, and you do not want to do something. Oh, I don't want to do homework. You are the karta of the homework, but you do not want to remain the karta of the homework. The mother forces you to do the homework till there is playtime. Until you reach playtime, homework is not over, she will force you to do. This is the role of Ishvara. So Hetu Karta is the mother. Ishvara plays the role of the parent there. So he makes you do. It is not that the parent won't punish. If the mother is soft on you, the father will punish when there is need for there is improvement, for your own improvement. Similarly, Ishvara does the same thing there. So thereby tachrute esha eva sadhu karma karati ityadi kayaha shrutehe. Such shrutis are there due to those shrutis. What the Siddhanti is saying is right, that Jiva is a karta, but he is a dependent karta, he is Ishwaradhina. Tasya Ishwarasya, meaning kartrutvam is Ishwaradhina, but still he has a choice. Tasya Ishwarasya, therefore what Tasya Ishwarasya, hetu kartrutvam avasiyata ityartha. Definitely there is hetu kartrutvam in Ishwara, and that does not take away the kartrutvam of jiva, nor does it show any virodha between them. This is seen in loka also. Now imagine this, somebody wants to study, another student does not want to study. Now one who makes them study is the teacher. So therefore what? Chaitraha patati, Maitraha na patati. But the teacher, Pathaka pathayati, Acharyaha pathayati. The Acharya is teaching both the student Chaitra and Maitra. Therefore Acharya is Hetukarta. But who is he really making do? Chaitra wants to study. Therefore Chaitraha patati, and the causative karta is Acharya. Where is the virodha? Maitra does not want to study. So Acharya tries to make him study without any bias. But then he says, no, I do not understand. He puts more effort there to get him done. Get him done with his studies and move on. That is one case possible. Or Maitra does not want to study, and the Acharya has to punish. Because having spent so much of effort, the student, the teacher, and the student's parents also having struggled so much, now Maitra is giving up. So some Ichha has to be created. So Samskaras have to be manifest. So some other approach is taken, a softer or a hard approach, so that Maitra starts studying. Whether to study or not to study is still with this entity Chaitra and with this entity Maitra. That is not taken away. So there is no contradiction at all. There is no virodha. Nanu Ishwarasya karayitritve vaishamya nairgunye syatam ityata ah. Although the example covers what is coming up, still this Purvapakshi does not know as to Ishvara is getting things done based on the kartrutva and the samskaras of the jiva. Nanu Ishwarasya karayitritve, if Ishvara is hetukarta, makes others do, then vaishamya nairgunya. But this has already been seen in the earlier adhikarana, as to there is no vaishamya nairgunya in Ishvara, meaning Ishvara does not give different phalas to different jivas based on his own bias, his own partiality. There is no partiality. Vaishamya. And Nairgunya, if you say he is giving phala without any basis, then not only partiality but also what? Looking at the state of the prapancha, you have to say that he is cruel, because many people are in lot of dukkha. Everyone has more dukkha than sukha. The balance is clear that most jivas have more dukkha than sukha. It may not be, you know, dukkha which makes you cry throughout the day. Not that kind of dukkha, but sorrow is there. There is effort involved to make ends meet for many. Even if the ends are met, one is who is living a luxurious life, but still family life isn't helpful to generate sukha, there is dukkha. So if you weigh the options, then parikshaloka, what? Karmachitaha brahmano nirvedamayat. There will definitely be vairagya if anybody thinks, anybody uses buddhi and analyzes one's own experiences. Without much experience, if one can analyze through others' experiences, well and good. You don't have to really have all experiences to analyze them. But even with your own experiences also, you can analyze. And anyone who analyzes will see that there is more dukkha, or at least the sukha that one is seeking. If one is not people will call that person a pessimist. So he'll say, no, I am not a pessimist, trying to defend himself, giving up his realistic analysis, he'll become an optimist. So even with optimism, if he say, analyzes, I am hopeful to get this sukha, which is nitya, if he analyzes that, has it been the case any time that the sukha has lasted beyond a certain point of time? After that, there has been definite dukkha, at least in seeking back and bringing that sukha back to the table. Therefore, vairagya is going to be the end result, says the Mundaka Shruti. Now, that being the case, if many of the jivas, most of the jivas are in dukkha most of the time, then Nairgunya. Ishvara has to be cruel if he is giving this kind of a phala without any basis. So if you say he is making others do, like Duryodhana said, we looked at that example. Somebody who is sitting within is prodding me to act. That is the role of Ishvara. But it is not without basis. So, Vaishamya Nairgunya Syatam Ityataha Ishvarasya Karyetritve. There, Sutrakara says, Kruta Prayatna Pekshastu Vihita Pratishiddha, Kruta Prayatna Pekshastu Vihita Pratishiddha Vayarthyadibhyaha. Kruta Prayatna Pekshastu Vihita Pratishiddha Vayarthyadibhyaha. Kruta Prayatna Pekshaha Tu Vihita Pratishiddha Vayarthyadibhyaha. So three words, two being in between, other two are on the left and the right, are samasas. So krutaprayatna is what? Krutaprayatna yena, or krutaprayatnaha yena in plural. So one by whom prayatnas are done. Bahuri. But this person, Krita Prayatnaha, and what is that? Krita Prayatnaha Apekshaha. Krita Prayatna to Krita Prayatna Apeksha. So Krita Prayatna is not a Bahuri, Krita Prayatna Apeksha is a Bahuri. So Ishvara is who? Krita Prayatna Apekshaha. Ishvara is Krita Prayatna Apeksha, which is a Bahuri. So Krita and Prayatna are in Karmadharya, but in Bahuri you don't need to make टू डिफरेंट समासास यू कैन गिव इन अ सिंगल विग्रह वाक्य. सो कृताः प्रयत्नः और कृतेषु प्रयत्नेषु अपेक्षा यस्य ईश्वरस्य सह ईश्वर कृत प्रयत्न अपेक्षः. सो दिस ईश्वर इज वन हु हैज अपेक्षा ऑफ कृत प्रयत्न. सप्तमी ऑल्सो पॉसिबल, षष्टी ऑल्सो पॉसिबल. इंडिवृत्ति द फर्स्ट समासा इज गिवन, द सेकेंड समासा इज गिवन विद अ समस्त पद इटसेल्फ. सो कृत यह प्रयत्न धर्माधर्म लक्षण तदपेक्षा एव ईश्वर, ईश्वर इज तदपेक्षा. तदपेक्षा मीन्स ही हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन समथिंग. ऑन वॉट? ऑन प्रयत्न विच इज मेड बाय जीवा. जीवेन कृत यह प्रयत्न और कृताः ये प्रयत्नाः, ऑल दोज प्रयत्न विच हैव बीन डन बाय जीवा, विच आर वॉट? धर्म धर्म लक्षण, कैरेक्टराइज बाय धर्म एंड धर्म. दे आर ऑल धर्म एंड अधर्म, पुण्य पाप कर्म. सो बेसिकली वॉट? कर्म, जीव कर्म. दैट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कृत प्रयत्न. सो कर्म अपेक्षा, जीव कर्म अपेक्षा इज ईश्वर. ईश्वर इज वन हू हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन जीव कर्म. सो लुक एट इट, देर इज अ इंटरडिपेंडेंसी, म्यूचुअल डिपेंडेंसी बिटवीन ईश्वर एंड जीव. ईश्वर कैनॉट क्रिएट संसार विदाउट जीव कर्म. जीव कैनॉट एक्ट विदाउट ईश्वर इच्छा, विच इटसेल्फ इज बेस्ड ऑन जीव कर्म. जीव गिवन द इंडिपेंडेंसी टू डू एनीथिंग एंड एवरीथिंग विदाउट ईश्वर कंट्रोलिंग, देन जीव विल एंड अप डूइंग वॉट एवर इज नॉट गुड फॉर हिमसेल्फ एंड अदर्स ऑल्सो. मे नॉट डू राइट एवरी टाइम. Jiva cannot keep on going and having all the bhogas if it is not controlled by circumstances. Circumstances have to be there to keep a check on Jiva so that he gets only what is due. Further what he generates, further karma that he generates, that's in his control. But the circumstances have to be created in such a manner that what is due should be given, whether it is good or bad. Whether it is good for the jiva or whether it is seen as good for the jiva by the jiva, that is irrelevant. But what is to be given based on the past karma, that only Ishvara can give. Future karma has to be generated by jiva, which he has a choice in. However limited, he does have a choice. Somebody feels that, okay, my free will is free. I have absolutely no dependency on anyone. Well and good. Act out. Many feel that even if I try, I cannot get things done. Why? Prarabdha is like that. Earlier karma is blocking. Badha is there. So many times, I try to do the patha in time, can't do. Why? Badhas are there, samskaras are there, whatever it is. We don't know what it is. We start doing some guesswork. Based on what? Based on our own current anubhava. My anubhava is like this, so I guess that my earlier karma may have been like this, or what I, I shouldn't have slept late yesterday. Whatever is the case, I tried to sleep, I did not get sleep. I should not have slept in the afternoon. So many variables are there, even with a single example. Then with so many jivas, so many anubhavas are there, so many guessworks are possible, but no one can say idam ittam. Therefore, past karma not being known, the circumstances have to be created by Ishvara so that every jiva gets what is due, which is a promise made by Ishvara. Therefore, there is a dependency for kartrutva bhoktrutva also on Ishvara from jiva's perspective. Though he is an independent karta, Bhokta, because he is Swatantra also. And from the Ishvara's perspective, he cannot give anything and everything the way he, based on his whims also, the way he wishes. Therefore, there is no Vaishamya Nairgunya. He has dependency on Jiva Karma. therefore krita prayatna apekshaha tu parameshwaraha. Therefore what tu means? What vaishamya nairgunye na syatam. Never can there be a case that Ishvara has vaishamya or nairgunya, which has been covered earlier. Vihita pratisheda vayartha dibhyaha. The hetu given is vihita vayarthya and pratishiddha vayarthya, and it is given in plural. All the vihita meaning vidhis and pratishiddha karma meaning what should not be done, that has been told. So those vakyas which are giving the vihita karma and pratishiddha karma, they will become vayartha, vyartha. They will have vayartha means they will become vyartha due to such hetus. Adi is there, adipada is also there. Because if the vidhi and nishedha has been given by the shruti, who will the vidhi apply to? Only to the karta. So if you say the jiva is not karta, then also it is futile. Meaning Ishvara is independently making the jiva do something, then vidhi is irrelevant. Similarly, pratishedha is also irrelevant. This is the reason that Ishvara has dependency on jiva's karma. Tuhu ukta shanka nirasartha. This tu shabda in the sutra is to remove the doubt as to what Puropakshi is saying is not right. Let it not confuse you. Jivena krataha yaha prayatnaha. What is that prayatnaha? Whatever effort the jiva has taken, by jiva whatever effort has been made towards whichever phala he wanted, which is what dharma dharma lakshanaha. Dharma and adharma are the very characteristic of that prayatna. When he is making any prayatna, there is some dharma guiding or some adharma. Of course, neutral is also there. I mean, he is not considering any of that. But then there will be some dharma involved, adharma involved in his prayatna. Tadapekshaha. That Ishvara is tadapeksha, has dependency on this dharma dharma lakshana prayatna of the jiva, made by the jiva. Tadapeksha eva Ishvaraha. Anyasmin api janmani dharmadikam karayati. Based on the purva prayatna made by the jiva, whether it is kayika karma, vachika karma or manasika karma, all these are known to Ishvara. And that Ishvara in anyasmin janma, in another janma, anyasmin api janmani, in another janma also, not only in this janma, but in any janma, without the jiva knowing his background, gives the phala and causes the jiva to continue to be a karta. Dharma adhikam, dharma adharma ityadi karayati, makes the jiva act. Tadapekshascha sukhadi phalam prayachati. And for bhoga, is he the jiva free? No. For bhoga also, tadapekshascha, based on the very karma of the jiva, which is dharma dharma lakshana prayatna, sukhadi phalam prayachati, also gives the sukhadi, sukha dukkha ityadi phalas. Na vaishamya nairgunya prasajyeta iti, iti heto, because of this reason that the kartrutva as well as bhoktrutva of jiva is based on his own karma, but given by Ishvara, so that there is, you know, there is no buffet. You know, it is not that you can take whatever you want. In bhoga, there is nothing like that. You cannot have that. Unless it is due, you will not get that bhoga. So there is no free lunch. So there is someone who is there to serve you. You okay, there is a possibility, you it's a buffet, but it is not self-service. You can go and take whatever you want, as much as you want, but there will be a person serving. That person will decide based on your own ichcha, how much you want. Because, you know, there are some shy people, they want, but they don't take. So it has to be served forcibly. You ask them twice, then they'll take. No, no, I don't want, but then they'll take. So similarly, karma phala also, jiva may say, I do not want. He may show that he does not want, but he has to be given. It's just an example to drive home the point. Because karma, you can think in many ways, it will be endless. You can never know idam ittham. Gahana karmano gatihi, says Bhagavan Krishna in Gita. It's very deep. It's the secret which can never be known, because it is so complex. The mind wanders. So I used to, especially in Mumbai, in Mumbai trains, you travel, you will get Vairagya. Since many years. So in 2000, I left Mumbai because I was fed up of the crowd. I used to look at the crowd and used to just looking at that crowd, I used to think, just like I have a family, I have my parents, I have my siblings, I have my friends, I have my colleagues. Similarly, there is a world for each of these individuals that I am seeing. How vast is the prapancha? How vast is their karma? All of us put together, how vast is our karma? And every moment, everything is in order. It is mind-boggling. So you cannot think of this karma. It is endless. I mean, one can go mad but still never get any concrete answer. Broad category we know. Even the siddhas cannot know anything and everything about everyone. So it is that deep a subject. No matter how many PhDs are done on this, one can never really get everything. It is just not possible. Therefore, there is someone who is Sarvajna, that can be Paramatma alone, who controls this Vyavastha. And everything goes on meticulously. Anaditva samsarasya purva janma kruta dharmadyapeksha yukta eva. And samsara is anadi. Anaditva samsarasya. Samsara is anadi. It has always been there. It is not that one day, a mukta purusha has become a samsari. Because that is what you'll have to say. If at all, samsara is not anadi. Avidya krita samsara is not anadi. Because avidya is not anadi. If that is the misunderstanding, then before avidya, there has to be vidya. Before this samsara was created, avidya cannot be there, because samsara is avidya krita. It is due to avidya. So if samsara has a beginning, then in time t, then before that time t, there has to be vidya, which is muktavastha. So why did this mukta become baddha again and have samsara at time t? If there is a reason, then that reason has to be given. There is no such reason. In fact, this is the subject matter of the discussion a couple of days back on somewhere. So this is the logic I presented, which is given in the Shastras. It is not my logic or anything. It is all in the Sampradaya, taught in the Sampradaya. It is there in the Bhashya Tikas, Yakhyas. So before time T, if there was Vidya, then that is Mukti Avastha. In that Mukta Avastha, how did samsara start? No reason is given. If somebody gives a reason, then what will happen? Whether that reason, if there is reason R1 that caused samsara at time T, then that reason itself, is it Adi, Sadi or Anadi? Does it, that reason have a beginning, or that reason is without beginning, if it is beginningless? If it is beginningless, then if R1 is beginningless, reason 1 which caused the mukta to become baddha basically cause samsara, cause avidya. From avidyavastha, if one has to go to from vidyavastha, one has to go to avidyavastha and become a samsari, then at time t, then R1 causing it, is R1 with a beginning or without beginning? Is it sadhi or anadi? If it is anadi, then might as well accept avidya as anadi. If it is sadhi, then another reason has to be given. If at all there is a reason. If there is no reason, then you have to say there is no reason. Then second paksha, if R1 is not without reason, the reason one given for beginning of avidya, triggering avidya, then that R1, if it is, meaning R1 is not given, avidya is without reason, avidya has a beginning without reason at time t, then there is nirmoksha prasanga, anirmoksha prasanga, there won't be moksha at all. There won't be nitya moksha. Nishchaya nitya moksha is not going to be possible, so anirmoksha prasanga. Why? Because without reason, if the mukta is becoming baddha, is having samsara, avidya can crop up again, then all the shastra is futile, because after so many janmas, because now I cannot say after infinite janmas, I have to say after so many janmas, because there was a beginning sometime, again I have become free and there is no guarantee that I'll not become baddha again, because without reason, just like time t, now after mukti, now also there can be samsara, avidya can crop up anytime. Therefore, if you say avidya has a beginning, then if you give a reason, then you'll have to give another reason and yet another reason, and thereby there will be anavastha dosha. Because you give R2, if it is without reason, then arir moksha prasanga. If there is reason for R1, then you'll have to give R2. That R2, whether it has a beginning or has no beginning, again same analysis will apply, and you keep on going, there will be ad infinitum, there will be infinite regress, which is anavastha dosha. So either you will have anavastha dosha, anirmoksha prasanga, to avoid all of that, what should you do? You have to accept avidya to be anadi. So samsara is anadi, anaditva samsarasya, since samsara is anadi because avidya is anadi, purva janma kruta dharmadya peksha yukta eva. Therefore, when Ishvara gives the circumstances in prarabdha for every jiva in this particular janma of each and every jiva, purva janma kruta dharmadya peksha, dharma dharma dependency of Ishvara to create such kind of a circumstance for each and every jiva is definitely yukta, it is but logical. Nanu kasma tad apekshatvam atah. Why do you need such an apeksha? Why can't jiva be depending on Parameshwara completely? It is not that jiva does not have kartrutva and is dependent on Parameshwara only, meaning it is not that there is a hetu karta without karta. There cannot be ni karta without anikarta. Anikarta has to be there. Atah vihita pratishiddha. Vita pratishiddha avyartha bhibhya. So avyartha bhibhya. Vita pratishiddha avyartha bhibhya. So vihita will become vyartha and pratishiddha will become vyartha, because only if the jiva has kartrutva, then he can be given a vidhi or pratishedha. You do this, do not do this, can be said only if you are the doer. Anyway, as a joke, you see in many places, you know, somebody is dressed up like a waiter, uniform is similar, and somebody gets confused and says, you bring me this. He is not the waiter. So you cannot tell him, you know, bring me tea, or say, take this away, or do not do this. Because he is not the waiter, it is not his job, he is not the waiting karta. Only if he is a waiting karta, you can tell him, do this, don't do this. You can say, bring my meal and put less oil, salt, spice, whatever. So that vidhi and pratisheda you can give only when he is the waiting karta. Similarly, Ishvara can give a vidhi and pratisheda through the shastras only if there is a karta. So that kartrutva should be there. Tadapekshatvam. There has to be jiva karma apeksha. Only then Ishvara can say, based on your karma, I am giving you vidhi, do this, do not do that. You have been born in this janma because you have a background of karma which helps me carve out that phala due to you in this janma as a human being. In this particular desha kala, in this family, in this varnashrama ityadi. So, vihita pratishiddha avayarthyadibhyaha ईश्वरस्य कर्मापेक्षत्वे ज्योतिष्टोमिने यजेत ब्राह्मणो न हन्तव्या इति द्वयोः विहित प्रसिद्धयोः अवयर्थ्यं भवति. ओनली देन देयर विल बी अवयर्थ्यं. ओनली देन देयर विल बी नॉन पर्पसफुलनेस. देयर विल बी सॉरी हाउ डू यू से यू नो देयर विल बी पर्पसफुल. लिटरली इफ यू ट्रांसलेट इट विल बी व्हाट व्यर्था विल बी यूजलेस. And avyartha will be what? Non-useless. So, double negative really. So, it will be like not purposeful. Only then it will be not purposeful, meaning it will be purposeful. Only then the vidhi and nisheda will be purposeful. What is that? Examples are given. Only Ishvarasya कर्मापेक्षत्वे जीव कर्मापेक्षत्वे. ओनली वेन ईश्वरा हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन जीव कर्म टू मेक द जीवा डू समथिंग नॉट डू समथिंग देन ओनली ज्योतिष्टोमिने यजेत स्वर्ग काम. तो स्वर्ग काम शुड डू ज्योतिष्टोम. दैट इज अ विधि. ब्राह्मणो न हंतव्य. ब्राह्मण शुड नॉट बी हर्ट, शुड नॉट बी किल्ड. ब्रह्महत्या. That is a nisheda. Iti dvayoho. So one is a vidhi, other is a pratisheda. So vihita pratishiddha yoho, vakya yoho, avayarthyam syad. Only then they'll be meaningful. Avayarthyam bhavati. Anyatha vidhi nisheda shastram anarthakam eva syad. Otherwise definitely they'll be purposeless. Evancha ईश्वराधीन कर्तृत्व प्रतिपादक विद्यादि शास्त्रेण एष जीव साधु कर्म इत्यादि शास्त्रस्य न विरोध इति सिद्धम्. सो साधु कर्म पुण्य कर्म कारयति, पाप कर्म कारयति बेस्ड ऑन दैट वेरी सेट ऑफ कर्मास विच आर ड्यू टू फ्रक्टिफाई देन दो संस्कारास विल मैनिफेस्ट सो दैट ही गेट्स दैट सुख और दुख. एंड देयर बाय व्हाट दुर्योधन सेड. Duryodhana still has a choice. Within, sitting within, Ishvara is prodding him to act out Punya and Papa. But he has also given Dharma Shastra, and even Bhagavan Krishna himself is saying, do not do this, do this. Duryodhana's confusion is every Jiva's confusion really. But one is free to decide. Becoming Suyodhana, one can decide. Buddhi has a role to play which is blessed with by Ishvara. Every jiva is blessed with buddhi. So with that blessed buddhi, one can decide, weigh out the options as to what one needs to do or not do. Ityadi shastrasana virodha. Therefore, kartrutva bhoktrutva is blessed by Ishvara based on that वेरी जीव कर्म. इत्थं नित्यत्वं स्वप्रकाशत्वं व्यापित्वं अकर्तृत्वं च आत्मन अभिधाय तदनन्तरं तस्य ब्रह्माभेद योग्यस्य ब्रह्मैक्यं साधयति इति हेतुहेतुमद्भावसङ्गत्य इदमाह. सो दि परायत्ताधिकरणम् इज ऑल्सो ओवर. नेक्स्ट अधिकरण इज अंशाधिकरणम्. दिस जीव इन दि बद्ध अवस्था, although non-different from Ishvara, is an Aumsha of Ishvara. Why an Aumsha? Because everything that the Ishvara has, Jiva has in very limited capacity. Ishvara in the physical body is विराट, बट जीवा हैज वन लिमिटेड बॉडी ऑफ अ लिमिटेड जेंडर ऑफ अ लिमिटेड स्पीशीज. सो अ लिमिटेड स्पीशीज एंड देन अ लिमिटेड जेंडर इन अ लिमिटेड लोका इन अ लिमिटेड ज्योग्राफी इन अ लिमिटेड काला. बट ईश्वरा इज नॉट लाइक दैट. देयरफॉर देयर इज अंशांशी भाव एट द स्थूल शरीर लेवल ऑल्सो. एट द सूक्ष्म शरीर लेवल ईश्वरा इज हिरण्यगर्भ और सूत्रात्मा. एंड दिस जीवा इज हैविंग लिमिटेड मनः लिमिटेड बुद्धि. कैनॉट बी सर्वज्ञ इज अल्पज्ञ. ईश्वरा इज सर्वज्ञ. एंड एट दी वेन इन सुषुप्ति ऑल्सो जीवा हैज आनंद. बट वॉट कैंड ऑफ आनंद डज दी जीवा हैव? जीवा हैज लिमिटेड आनंद. वाई लिमिटेड? बिकॉज हिज स्वरूप इज कवर्ड. दैट इज द लिमिटेशन. बट ईश्वरा इज हैविंग अनंत आनंद. देयरफॉर इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट सर्व इज द विशेषण एट द ईश्वराज लेवल एंड अल्प इज द विशेषण एट द जीवाज लेवल. देयरफॉर देयर इज अंशांशी भाव. एवरी कैरेक्टरिस्टिक इज द सेम बट इन एम्पलीट्यूड इन क्वांटिटी इट इज different. There is a huge difference. Therefore amsha amshi bhava is there in the jiva samsara jiva avastha. Samsara avastha samsari jiva has this amshatva bhava, whereas amshi is ishvara. But there is abheda. Even with the abheda there is amsha amshi bhava during samsara when there is ajnana. सो इत्थम नित्यत्वं स्वप्रकाशत्वं व्यापित्वं अकर्तृत्वं च आत्मना अभिधाय. आत्मा जस्ट गिव मी वन मोमेंट. इज दैट राइट? ओके. सो इत्थम इन दिस मैनर नित्यत्वं. आत्मा इज नित्य स्वप्रकाश. आत्मा आल्सो व्यापी. आत्मा इज नॉट लिमिटेड इन हृदयाकाश. इज व्यापी व्यापक तत्व. सो चैतन्य सच्चित एंड दि व्यापकत्व मीनिंग देश परिच्छेद नॉट बीइंग देयर दैट हैज बीन डिस्कस फर्दर. व्हाट हैज बीन सेड? आत्मा शुद्ध आत्मा इज नॉट कर्ता. सो अकर्ता. बट विद द उपाधि संबंध इज डेफिनेटली अ कर्ता बेस्ड ऑन दिस कर्तृत्व एंड दि धर्माधर्म लक्षण प्रयत्न. ईश्वर क्रिएट्स and create samsara for this jiva and then karayati makes the jiva act. So having discussed that abhidhaya tadantaram, after that what is being done now? Tasya atmanah brahma abheda yogyasya, who is absolutely non different from paramatma, from brahma, para brahma bheda ब्रह्म अभेद योग्यस्य. योग्यता इज डेफिनेटली देयर बिकॉज बुद्धि हैज बीन गिवन वेयर बाय वन कैन टेक अवे ऑल द उपाधीज. बट विद द उपाधीज व्हाट? देयर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ द जीवा बीइंग कॉल्ड एज ईश्वरा बिकॉज देयर इज सर्व एज विशेषण ऑन वन हैंड एंड अल्प एज विशेषण ऑन द अदर. तस्य आत्मना ब्रह्माभेद योग्यस्य ब्रह्मैक्यं साधयति. ऐक्य विद ब्रह्मा इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एस्टैब्लिशेस दि सूत्रकार एस्टैब्लिश साधयति इति हेतु हेतु मत भाव संगत्या. सो दि नित्यत्वं स्वप्रकाशत्वं व्यापित्वं अकर्तृत्वं दीज आर ऑल ब्रह्म ब्रह्मात्मा और परब्रह्म धर्मास कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स और स्वरूप ऑफ परब्रह्म. एंड आत्मा इज ऑल्सो नित्य स्वप्रकाश व्यापी एंड अकर्ता. Therefore, those dharmas are there in Atma also, Jivatma. Thereby, now these Nityatva, Saprakashatva, Vyapitva, Akartrutva, which have been established in earlier Adhikaranas, that is the Hetu. And Hetumat is what? Brahma Veda. Therefore, all these Brahma dharmas being there in Jiva also, Jiva is none other than Brahma. But if the quantity has to be seen as limited, in any of the aspects vyapi, but only anaka paryantebhya, anaka paryantam. If he is vyapi only up to the tip of the nails, then limited. This swaprakashatvam also what? Has jnana but alpajna, does not know anything and everything. Nityatva also what? Yes, nitya, but does not really know so. That is nitya. With the body he thinks that I am going to die. So body dies, until then he is there. So in Sushupti he is there, he knows, okay, I was there. In Sushupti I was there, I did not die. But Sharira dying, I die, this is the misunderstanding. So Nityatva is also limited. Akartrutvam, although Swarupa Akartrutva, in Sushupti I am not a Karta. But in Swapna I am a different kind of a Karta, in Jagradavastha I am a different kind of a Karta. So Kartrutva, Akartrutva is also limited. In only in one avastha out of the three I am Akarta. So thereby you can see some Alpata in all these aspects as well. Thereby Brahmaikyam Sadeti Aumsha Aumshi Bhava is going to be discussed here in Aumshadikarana. Aumsho Nana Vyapadeshad Anyatha Chapi Dasha Kitavaditvam Adhiyata Eke. Aumsho Nana Vyapadeshad Anyatha Chapi Dasha Kitavaditvam Adhiyata Eke. Eke Aumshaha Nana Vyapadeshat Anyatha Cha Api Dasha Kitavaditvam Adhiyata Adhiyate Eke. Eke Eke Shakinaha. Some Atharvana Shaka followers Adhiyate, they chant this mantra or they have this mantra in this manner. What is that? Aumshaha. Jiva is Aumsha of Ishvara. Why? Nana Vipadeshat. Because of many things being said. Nana. Because see, if Nana, many things are said about something, meaning the jivas are many. Let's just say jivas are many. Then what will happen? This jiva being many, Ishvara is one, so jiva has to be Aumsha. Because Swarupa wise, jiva has the same Satchidananda as Ishvara, but jivas are many. So all jivas cannot be having complete Ishvara Bhava. Therefore, Aumshas of Satchidananda are there in each and every jiva. So Nanatvatse Vyapadeshat, because jiva being many is taught, that can be one meaning. I am giving just the Mula, one meaning on the Mula, which is a possible meaning whereby we can understand the Sutra and go to details in the Vritti. And try to avoid some repetition. Anyatha, anyatha chapi. Anyatha means what? Nana Vyapadesha is also there. And Nana Vyapadesha will mean what? There are many jivas. And many jivas cannot be one Ishwar also. Therefore, there is difference also. As soon as you say Nana, there is a difference seen. Difference between jiva and jiva. And many jivas are there. How can many jivas be one? Therefore, there is a difference which is inferred as well. And it is, since Nanatva itself is taught by the Shruti, therefore we see that there is difference between Jiva and Paramatma. Jiva and Jiva also. So that is the Nanatva there. So multiple meanings are possible. But what should we land on? Nana Vyapadesha and Anyatha. Anyatha Chapi. Anyatha Chapi Vyapadesha, meaning Ananatva. Ananatva is what? Abheda. So Bheda is also taught, Abheda is also taught. And what is he? Ek. And some Shakhi, Ek Shakhi Naha, what do they adhiyate, what do they chant? Dasha Kitavaditvam. They say what? Being what? See, all these are, you know, words which talk about the nanatvam, as in being what? Fishermen. Dasha is fishermen. And Kitava, Kitava, so you see, Dashaha Kaivarta, Dasaha Bhritya, Kitavaha Dyutakruta, gamblers. So there is so much talked about as fishermen, as, you know, as devotees, as what, as gamblers. So that is in Anatva. So what is this Brahma? They talk about Brahma itself, Brahma Dasha. So the mantra, this I'll just mention, so that what is this, you know, being fishermen and being servants or devotees or being gamblers, what is this that is chanted in Atharvaveda Shaka? So they say Brahma Dasha, Brahma Dasa, Brahma Eva Ime Kitavaha. So who is Brahma? Brahma is one who is also in the form of fishermen, he is also in the form of servants, and Brahma is also in the form of gamblers. So you can see Bheda also, Abheda also. So that is what is said here. So what is Bheda as well as Abheda also? So you see Aumsha Aumshi Bhava. Aumsha is one in quality with the Aumshi. And in quantity is different. Therefore, Bheda and Abheda both are possible. That is the meaning of the Sutrartha, meaning the Shruti talks about Jiva as an Aumsha. How? Through Nanatva and Ananatva. Through Bheda and Abheda. Therefore, there is no Virodha. It is to show in the Jiva, Samsari Jiva, Avastha, this Jiva is an Aumsha of Ishvara Paramatma. Atra, with this background, it should be easy to go through. Atra tattvamasi ityadya bheda shruti jatasya atmani tishta nityadi bheda shruti jatena virodha astinava iti sandehe. Purva Pakshi says tattvamasi shows aikya, tattvamasi you are Brahma. And then what iti abheda ityadi abheda shruti jatasya. The group of Mahavakyas which are showing Abheda between Jiva and Brahma. Then you Atmani Tishtan, that Yaha Paramatma, who being in the Sharira, in the Jiva, being what? He makes the person act Atmani Tishtan. So how can he be in the Jiva if Jiva is one with Paramatma? How can Paramatma be in Jiva? Therefore, there is Abheda also, Abheda also, Ityadi, Bheda Shruti Jatena. So, there are a group of non-Mahavakyas which are showing Bheda, and then there are Mahavakyas which are showing Abheda. Therefore, between the Abheda Shruti Jata, Samuha, Jata means Samuha, group. So, between the Abheda Shruti group and the Bheda Shruti group, Virodha, Astinava, is there a contradiction or not? When such a doubt is there, Jiveshwariho Purvokta Purvokta Upakaryo Upakaraka Bhavastha Swami Bhrityavat Bhedadina Sambandha Sapekshatvat Tad Abheda Shruti Jatene Virodhasti Iti Purva Paksha. Purva Pakshi says there is definitely contradiction between the two sets of Shrutis, Abheda Shruti and Bheda Shruti. Why? He says what has been stated earlier, Jiva Ishwariho Purvokta. What is that? Upkarya, Upakarya, Upakari, Upakari, Upakaraka, Upakarya, it will become Upakaryo Upakaraka. Bhavasta. So Jiva is Karta, but is Ishwaradhina Karta. So what has been said earlier, this Jiva Ishwara, between Jiva and Ishwara, there is a Karta and Hetu Karta Sambandha. So servant does, but the master makes him do. The Bhritya servant does and Swami master makes the servant do. Therefore, there also you see Karta and Hetu Karta Sambandha. The Karta is Bhritya servant. But this, if servant does something wrong, what if someone says, oh, why did you do this? Oh, my master told me. So Swami is the Hetu Karta there. सिमिलरली व्हाट पूर्वोक्त उपकारी उपकारक भाव भावस्थ स्वामी भृत्यवत लाइक दि सर्वेंट एंड दि मास्टर दि जीव एंड ईश्वर संबंध हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश्ड अर्लियर हैज बीन शोन तद्वत व्हाट भेदाधीन संबंध सापेक्षत्वा सिमिलरली देर इज अपेक्षा ऑफ संबंध व्हाट काइंड ऑफ संबंध भेदाधीन विच इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन भेद विदाउट दि स्वामी एंड दि भृत्य इफ दे आर वन देर कैनॉट बी संबंध एट ऑल दि संबंध बिटवीन स्वामी एंड भृत्य इज पॉसिबल ओनली इफ देर इज भेद बिटवीन स्वामी एंड भृत्य सिमिलरली वॉट उपकारक उपकार उपकार उपकारी एंड उपकारक वन हू इज गेटिंग उपकार एंड वन हू इज मेकिंग एन उपकार दे हैव टू बी डिफरेंट सो वन हू इज हेल्पिंग हैज टू बी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दी हेल्प्ड दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन दी जीव एंड ईश्वर दे हैव टू बी डिफरेंट तर अभेद श्रुति जातेन सिंस दी कर्तृत्व हेतु कर्तृत्व संबंध विच हैज बीन शोन कर्ता हेतु कर्ता संबंध विच इज देर विच हैज बीन शोन अर्लियर दैट हैज डिपेंडेंसी ऑन भेद बिटवीन दी कर्ता एंड दी हेतु कर्ता एंड दी श्रुति इज सेइंग व्हाट तत्त्वमसि तद अभेद श्रुति जातेन जीवेश्वर अभेद श्रुति तद मीन्स जीव एंड ईश्वर सो बिटवीन जीव एंड ईश्वर देर इज अभेद दैट इज व्हाट अ ग्रुप ऑफ श्रुति महावाक्य से सो तदभेद श्रुति जाने विरोध अस्ति डेफिनेटली देर इज अ विरोध कॉन्ट्राडिक्शन बिकॉज भेद विदाउट भेद देर कैनॉट बी उपकारी उपकारक भाव स्वामी भृत्य भाव एंड दैट यू ऑलरेडी शोन विच इज भेदाधीन नाउ दि श्रुति विच इज सेइंग देर इज अभेद बिटवीन दि टू देर इज डेफिनेट विरोध इति पूर्व पक्ष सिद्धांतस्तु व्हाट डज द सिद्धांत से जीव ईश्वर से अंश इव अंश नॉट रियली अंश He's an aumsha iva aumsha, as though a part. Why he's as though a part or not a real part? Because Ishwara is what? Basically, Parameshwara, Brahma, Parabrahma is niraumsha. Parameshwara does not have any parts. Where are the parts in Ishwara, Parabrahma? Parabrahma is Shuddha Satchidananda Ghana. It is Ghana. There cannot be any division. There are no parts. Therefore, Aumsha, when it is said, it is figuratively an Aumsha Iva Aumsha, Natu Swabhavika Aumsha, not really an Aumsha at all. Tasya Nishkalam Ityadina Niraumshatva Shravanat, because Shruti says Brahma is Nishkala, Avidyamanaha or Nirgata, here Nish, so Nirgata, Nirgataha Kalaha Yasmat, Brahmana Tad Brahma Nishkalam Brahma. That Brahma is partless, has to be partless and there cannot be Aumsha. Aumsha is a part. Kala and Aumsha, there is no difference. Kala means a part, Aumsha means a part. And if the Shruti says that Brahma is Nishkalam, then it means that Brahma is Niraumsha. Thereby Niraumshatva Shravanat. Ataha Kalpita Aumsha Jiva. So Aumsha, Iva Aumsha means what? Aumshatva is Kalpita in Jiva. Just like Kartrutva. So jiva being aumsha of ishvara is kalpita kalpita aumsha jiva kutaha punar jiveshwarayoh aumsha aumshi bhavah so kutaha punaha jiveshwarayoh aumsha aumshi bhava why is it that you say then there is an aumsha aumshi bhava why do you have to do such a kalpana also as the purva pakshi ya atmani tishta nityadina tayor nana vyapadeshat nanatvatya cha vyapadeshat due to nanatva vyapadesha because ya atmani tishtan That Paramatma is in Atma and being in the Atma, Jivatma, whatever makes someone do or whatever, Ityadina, what Tayoho, Jiveshwaryo, Nana Vyapadesha, there is a difference taught between the two. Ishwara is one and then there are many Jivas. They are Aumshas of this Paramatma. Nanatva Secha Vyapadesha, because of the teaching of Nanatva, अन्यथा चापि अन्यथा मीन्स व्हाट अनानात्वस्य चापि व्यपदेशात् बिकॉज ऑफ टीचिंग ऑफ अभेद आल्सो there is bheda also taught, abheda also taught. When both are taught, then it is one is by quality, the other one is by quantity, and thereby there is an ausha ushi bhava. Tatha hi eke shakinaha atharvanikaha brahmadasha brahmadasa brahmai veme kitavaha iti dasha kitava adityam abhidiyate. Sorry, adhiyate. Dasha kitava adityam adhiyate. So they say this Brahma is one, and then there are dashas, there are kitavas, adi, dasas also. So adi padena dasa. So Brahma himself appears as what? Dasha. Dasha are kaivartaha, fishermen. Dasaha, vrityaha, servants, devotees. Kitavaha, dyutakrutaha, gamblers. Tadbhavam amananti. So they chant this Brahma bhava as well as Dasha bhava, Dasa bhava, Kitava bhava. So Brahma has, Brahma, because if he is Brahma, Brahma himself is Dasha, Dasa, then all these Dasha, Dasa should have Brahma bhava also. Whether they know or not, they have Brahmatva. And being Dasha, they have also Dashatva. Being Dasa, they have Dasatva. Being Kitava, they have Kitavatva. So there is a bheda and abheda also. Tadbhav amananti ityataha ananatvasya abhedasya cha vipadesha. There is nanatva also, ananatva also. Tatra bhedadi shruti jatasya pratyaksha siddha bhedanuvadena abheda paratva kalpita bheda bhedavan aushaha kalpita bhedavan aushaha jiva iti. So who is the jiva really? He is kalpita bhedavan, he ausha, he jiva is ausha of paramatma, but what ausha? Not real ausha, not swabhavika ausha, ausha eva ausha, as though a part of that partless brahma. So if you have to say as though a part of that partless brahma, then that aushatvam is what? Aushatvam is kalpita. So ausha is what? Kalpita bhedavan. Ausha is what? One who has a kalpita bheda. There is no real bheda. So bhedadi shruti jatasya tatra, the group of bheda shrutis which are talking about bheda ityadi pratyaksha siddha bheda anuvadena, the bhedadi shruti is not pramana at all. Only abheda shruti is pramana. Why? Because bhedadi shruti is just anuvada shruti. It is just telling you that which you already know. Their Shruti is not Pramana at all. Because it is, Bheda is what? It is Pratyaksha Siddha. Who would say that all these fishermen are not different from each other? Nobody says that fishermen are one and the same. Not all fishermen are one fisherman. Where is the scope of fishermen becoming servants and gamblers? If they are the same person, it is all right. But then, gamblers who are spending the entire day gambling, whereas fishermen are fishing and servants are serving their masters, they are three different groups. Even if you take an individual fisherman, an individual servant and an individual gambler, they being three different people, nobody says that they are one. Nobody even thinks that they are one. So this Bheda is already known. Why does Shruti have to say it? So if Shruti says it, it is only Anuvada Shruti. It is only repeating what you already know. So pratyaksha siddha bheda anuvadena bhedadi shruti jatasya abheda paratvat, and through that what? Abheda paratvat. Whatever is the bheda, what is the bheda? Kaivartaha, dashaha, dasaha and kitava are the bhedas. But brahma, samanadikaranam brahma dasha, brahma dasa, brahma eva ime kitava, therefore abheda paratvam. Through the Bheda, which is already known between fishermen, servants and gamblers, Shruti is saying all of those are Brahma. Therefore, Tatparya is to teach Brahmatva Bhava, Brahma Bhava, and thereby Tatparya being that Abheda Paratvam is there. It is showing Abheda with Brahma. Thereby the Bheda between Kaivarta, Vritya and Dyutakruta is also what? Aunsha Iva Aunsha Kalpita Bhedavan Aunshaha Jeevaha. therefore jiva is having kalpita bheda from brahma and therefore the aunshatva is also kalpitam, he is a kalpita ansha of paramatma. We'll see the next sutra in the next paatha. तो आमना एक संसिद्ध आदि मध्यांत वर्जित आनंद घन पूर्णमात्म ज्योतिरुपासमहे नमस्ते धन्यवाद।